guys, these guys. Hey, folks, welcome to Rock'em Sock'em 6. Hope you're enjoying these, I'll tell you, because Blue and I love bringing them to you. We're going to start with the most exciting thing, right, Blue? In hockey, the hip checks. Let's go!
My buddy Ty gets zonked by Stevens. And Toski catches Shaw. Snyder flips Smollett. Sergei Bodin lays a pretty one on McCarty. Weinrich, Joe Sillinger. Ludwig, he just catches Recchi. Ludwig again on Leach. Galley crunches Buckberger. And Buckberger's not too happy. Stern sent Jelena flying. And just to show I'm not prejudiced, here are some beauties by Kasparaitis. I don't like this one, folks. What she does to Kim. Boy, I can't stand it. Gotta admit, pretty good hitter, though. And that's it for the Kasper the Friendly Ghost Show. Here's some beauty 2-on-1, folks. Odd couple, Gino and Pavel. Over to Gino and in beauty. Get out of my way, Adam. Get out of my way. I want to talk to my buddy, Pavel. Look at that. Isn't that cute? Sacking to Chris Simon and in. Way to go, Chris boy. I like it. A different way to score on a 2-on-1. Boston Stewart shoots the puck, and Hine puts home the rebound. Short-handed Joe. Here's Sergei Fedorov. He looks like Guy Lafleur flying down the wing with the hair flowing. Not as fast as Guy. Nice pass back to Drake, and he slides her home. Watch the sweet hands of Paul Coffey here. Nice. How many times have we seen this? Watch Graves feather the puck to Messier, and he scores from his favorite spot. Burr scores a tough one here. Way to go, Sean. Way to use your head. He wasn't hurt. OT hero Craig Adams sets up Dana Murzyn, who beats Richter. They sure miss Murzyn in the playoffs, I'll tell you. The Flames Ruckel sets up Gary Roberts and he beats McLean. I love that Roberts. Isn't he a beauty? Here's another kind of 2-on-1. Two Canucks on Gilmore and Dougie doesn't take a backward step. The Norris Cody gets hammered by a flock of Hawks. Ty gets pounded by a pair of Wings. Messier and Graves hammer Kasparaitis. Ah, they let up on him. Burr and McCarty catch a shark with his head down and give him a rough ride. Leafs super pest Bill Burke plays the place as Lennon and Mameso hammer him. Two Norris hammer the Sabres Woods.
Hey, folks, one of the most embarrassing things, as Blue and I agree, is when you score in your own net. You ever notice that they're right in the middle all the time? That's murder, I'm telling you, folks. You want to crawl right under the ice if you can. Watch these guys put them in their own net. Right, Blue?
The Wings have a delayed penalty, so the Bruins pull their goalie. They try to pass it right to the point, and the defenseman misses the puck. And like I said, it goes right in the middle. Watch this now. Back to the point, right in the middle. What an awful feeling. I tell you something, Brian Sutter, you're not too happy about that one. Don't read lips now. Same thing happened to me in Colorado, Brian. Now the same thing happens to the Flyers' Soderstrom, or something like that. He just can't get back in time. Watch this one. Look, it goes right in the middle of the net again. And Tommy wants to know, does that count against my average? We've all seen this. The goalie makes a nice stop, and then the defenseman comes and knocks it in the net. This is one of the best. Watch Gerald Dinnick hammer the puck past Kirk McLean. The Flyer Dmitry Samatox, or whatever it is, clears the puck into his own net. Now, I'm not picking on him because he's a Russian. I just showed Daryl Dinnick, didn't I? Severin fakes to put it in the corner and puts it on net. Mike Murphy, what a play, eh, Pat? You won't believe this one, folks. Belford tries to clear the puck in overtime. Nelson Emerson grabs the puck. Now watch, he's skating out in front. He's got the puck in his hands. Eddie tries to stop him. He reaches around and throws it in the net. And believe it or not, they count it. The Hawks say, what, are you counting that? Sutter's not too happy. With video replay, how can they count a goal like that?
Tell you that the best part of hockey is the playoffs. We're gonna look last year's series, a couple of beauties. Blues ready to go already. Chicago and Toronto, let's go.
Some great hits in this series. Watch Captain Crunch Wendell Clark start it off. Keep the game tied. We're heading to overtime. Todd Gale wins the game in OT in game two. Belfour was hot. Thought he was interfered by Wendell. I think he was. The next two games are in Chicago, and they were just as rough as the first two. Gilmore was the target for the Hawks in the next two games. Watch him get run here. Look out! Dougie's a little upset here, I think. With the series at 2-1, Roenick wins game 4 in OT, and now it goes back to Toronto for a best of 2 out of 3. Is he happy or what? The hitting keeps going. Watch these two Volterras battle it out. Two great superstars playing it tough. I love it. No quarter given and none taken. Whoa, what a save. Even though the Hawks were down, they kept coming. Sutter sent Zezel flying. Captain Crunch nails Chelios and the Hawks are gone in 6. Are they going to miss Wendell or what? What a hit. Flames and Canucks. The Flames and Canucks, this one was the toughest series of all, folks. No prisoners were taken in this one. Oh, are they hitting? And they're hitting to hurt, I'll tell you. Watch these beauty hits. You better keep your head up in this series, I'll tell you. What a win. It's a battle of the goalies here, folks. The Sabres, Hasek had an average of under 2 and still lost the series. Did they miss Patty LaFontaine or what? Claude thinks it's in. Hasek stones Richey twice. The Muse scores and watch him skate by Hasek and say something. Go. Watch him now. He'll skate by and say something to Dominic. Now watch what Dominic does. Here it is. Oh yeah. Claude takes his dive and the fun begins. Rookie of the year, Martin Brodeur was just as good. He went save for save with Hasek. He's a beauty. Watch this one. Oh! 6. The Sabres need a win to stay alive, and it took until the fourth overtime before either team could score. And it was Davey Hannon who beat Brodeur to give the Sabres a win.
Go, 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 go.
Oh, way to go, Davey. But it was Claude Lemieux who got the beauty goal of the series, and the Devils win it in 7. The Bruins and the Habs. Is it my imagination, or does the Bruins and the Habs play every playoff? It's always rock'em, sock'em time when these two teams get together. Even the refs have to be careful in this series. Get out of the way, Dan! My buddy from Kingston, Kirk Muller, with the winner to give the Canadians a 3-2 series lead. But everybody knows the Bruins don't quit, and they go on to win the series in 7 games. Watch Raymond smoke this one by Patrick. Whoa!
Hey, folks, the most deadly thing in hockey is a slap shot. Goalie's nightmare, right? Hey, watch Cam Neely when he takes one. Watch the little twirl and he lets her go. Slap shots, let's go.
Cam Neely, is he a beauty? 50 goals in 49 games. Ray Bourque with 2. McKinnis lets 2 of his Rockets go. Boy, they're gonna love this guy in St. Louis. Yeah, Sheen. You know, I gotta admit, I like this guy. Stefan Richer launches 2 beauties. This one goes right through the net. Look. Paul Stewart, he's going over to check. Yeah, went through. Look. You can see the net go. Now that's a rock. Says we can't hammer a puck. Now that's a beauty. When the goal and Brett shoots. And nothing sweeter than a goalie making a beauty glove save. Glenn Healy.
Come on.
Trevor Kidd. They were that close from winning the series. A few minutes later, Mike Gardner scores the winner in OT. The Leafs go on to win the Game 7 and the series. Notice how most of those goals are from scrambles. You ever notice that? This was a brutal series, folks. Watch these Rockers. They weren't fooling around here. Two big teams going at it. Goaltending too. Watch Kirk McLean rob the Stars here. Andy Moog doing his playoff thing. In game four, Sergio Malmesso snaps the winner in OT. Top corner. Story was the elbow. Now Pavel was getting roughed up by the Stars, as you can see. The Stars were really running around. Taking abuse. Gets nailed by Ludwig, then Chirla comes down and gives him a shot. come down the ice and he takes it out on Chirla. Watch this elbow, the mother of all elbows. Watch, he's coming across Wango. Now watch the replay. Chirla never had a chance. He's still getting knocked around. But watch this, he cuts to his left. I'm sure Shane will be introducing himself to Pavel next year.
Can you guys both step ahead? Thank you.
Right. Yes, sir. Yes, it was. Thank you. Yes.
I'm sitting here trying to remember.
We see ourselves.
Let's have a look at the shot. Wide shot first, Glenn, just so we can check out the. I got to move tighter to you there.
Yeah.
Something too big.
That's good. Beauty.
Well done by both Kurt and
Yeah, Kurt come back pretty good.
What are you doing watching figure skating? That's what confuses me.
Well, I want to watch it and see the Winnipeg Jets, their next draft picks, that's all. A guy working for the Rangers got on, Al Earwig or something. What was his name?
Al Troutwig.
Troutwig, Fisher Troutwig or whatever.
Careful now. Well, Cherry is...
Yeah, all right.
What do you mean, Cherry?
Well, it's a name that Shane never has been connected with.
That's true.
What are you going to call me?
You're
going to call me a fruit?
Well, I'm just saying it's something like a fish. Anyway, carry on.
How could a cherry be like with a fish?
Well, it's a fruit if you're going food products.
Call me a fruit, folk. Cam Neely. Cam Neely. What a night. How do I get into these things?
In terms of I don't know. It's a very reasonable fact simpleton. Or simile, anyway. Don Cherry.
The best you ever looked.
Got two faces tonight.
Anyhow, I'm in Springfield. We're playing for Springfield, Siberia. The score is 3-0, end of the first, and we're down. And in comes the Prince of Darkness, Eddie Shore. He comes walking in. He starts picking on a defenseman for the first goal. And Marcel, a French guy, says, no, no, Eddie, my fault. So he starts in the second defenseman. He says, no, no, Eddie, my fault again. So he starts in the third defenseman for the third goal. He says, no, 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 my fault again, Eddie. So Shore turns now. Darth Vader turns to him and he says, okay, Mr. Paillet, then the whole three goals were your fault. He says, yeah, hat trick.
Did a great job. Yeah, tonight.
Yeah, tonight in Montreal.
Well, I was going to ask you about the other night.
All right, wait a minute. Now, don't ask the other night till I get through with what we're talking about tonight. Okay, now listen to this one. I'm going to give you an imitation of Kevin Collins, okay, when there's a fight on. Can I do that?
Sure.
Okay, here he is now. Watch this, folks. Here it is. There's, looks like there's going to be a fight. Stop now. Stop off the violence. You, over there. You, over there. Everybody.
Doing his job.
Drives me nuts. Animated.
Oh, yeah, you picked Calgary, incidentally, to win the Stanley Cup.
No, Ron, can I say something? I'm a little boy from Ontario here, down the road here, and, you know, I love the people in Alberta. I really do love the people, and I like them BC too, but, you know, why would you make fun of me for picking, you know, from your province town? You should go back. You should forget. I know you live in Oakville.
Toronto.
No, I like the people
of
Alberta.
Stick up for the people.
You live in Oakville now. You know how these people go from Alberta, they live, come here, make big money. You shouldn't make fun of the people. You should be like Barry Melrose. Go back to your roots and Red River, Red Deer. They're
Alberta.
Good people
the
there.
Juniors next year.
Don't feel.
Great people.
Yes. Well, don't make fun of me for picking your province.
You're going to see something very funny. Could be on Rock'em Sock'em.
Bob
6.
Bob Cole saw it.
Watch it.
It.
Well, Bob saw it. You know, he sees everything. But I never saw it. Let's see it right now. Watch this now. Everybody thinks the game's over, and they're, hey, game's over. Look at the crowd and everything. Now, watch. He goes to pass it, hits Ezel in the net. Felix says, what? What? I can't tell you. Is it Tabernacle? call it. What are you doing, Sylvain? Mon Dieu and all that stuff.
Don't think you can say that either.
Oh, can't you? I don't know what it means.
Probably get away with it.
Okay, good.
At the Memorial Cup, you can, apparently.
Yeah.
Making a big fuss about you here, and I don't know why. 2 years ago, Pavel Bure was a weasel. Now you're getting into
Hey, well, it's all right. Hey, the kid all of a sudden starts playing the old Canadian way, hitting and all that. You saw Chirla, McCallum, what he did the other night. We got a little
bad what he did to Chirla.
Yeah.
Well, but he's looking out for himself. What do you got?
Anyhow, what have I got here? And then leave your cappuccino alone. What is this here? Gorgeous.
Important, you want to learn to espresso yourself. You should try it.
Yeah, I don't have much time
here,
eh?
Go ahead.
Just, what are you? What's in the cappuccino?
Nothing.
Just sit there.
Milk.
All right. By the way, whoa, look out. Wait a minute. Hold. Look out. Get off. There they come again. Get off. They're back on the bandwagon again. It's funny.
Toronto Maple
You're all back on the bandwagon.
Don't look at me. I'm a neutral observer here, but...
Neutered. You're a neutered observer.
Well, calling a spade, sort of.
We've got a musical episode for you, okay?
Interlude, then.
All right, whatever you'd like to call it. And we'd like to roll it right now. Dings off the post, okay? Okay, roll it, Larry boy.
Excited about all the crossbars and how great they sounded. That's the net cam. That's the microphone.
Oh, is that right, eh?
Yeah, so it's
worth $100,000. Way to go, Ronnie Harrison.
Let's have a look at this. Joy, Cherry on the University hot seat. Well, McMaster University in Hamilton's going to do a study into you and your role in television. It goes on to say in this article, come back to us so that I can pretend this was live, me holding it so still. It says here... White discovered this year that many women are generally offended by Cherry's comments. He said, quote, by the time they left the discussion, although the guys loved him, I think we put a few question marks in the guys' heads. Some of them were thinking twice about the role of Don Cherry.
The one thing, left-wing pinkos, you didn't get a credit for that, and I'll tell you right now, can you imagine university getting a credit for that? But always remember, all women or girls love a sharp-dressed man. Always remember that all the time. Right, Rose?
It's just so you know, Bobby Orr is so special to you. It's really my job. I just want to go back to that refereeing thing again. The mistake I made the other night. It's my job to sometimes make myself sacrifice, look stupid, be the devil's advocate, to make you look good.
Look stupid.
Yeah.
And you outdid yourself, kid, I'll tell you. You really did. But it's so easy for you to be stupid.
Oh. Well, it doesn't bother me.
Doesn't bother you?
Contract's up at the end of the month. Hey, a lot of dough for a guy losing his mind. We got a little picture here going away.
What is the picture?
I don't know. Something.
Oh, you got the girl, eh? How about that? There's Blue at the game, too. Good guys. Way to find out. What? Isn't this they beautiful dogs? They're beautiful dogs. Beautiful dogs and Bobby Orr.
Won't affect me. Really, it won't.
Easy
I'm mature.
You.
I can...
You outdid yourself.
We're fallible. We're fallible.
Are we still on?
Yeah.
Are we?
Amazingly.
One of the most vicious and exciting series of the playoffs. Bad blood runs deep with these two teams. With less than a minute to go, and the Rangers are up by one, and the super fast Claude Lemieux ties the game in a scramble. In OT, both defensemen are caught, and only Graves and Messier are back. It's poor Adam Graves versus Richer. Coming down on his wrong side, it's tough. He beats Richer, and the Devils are up one game to none. We'll be right back. Hunter was great. Watch him stone the devil. Now in double overtime, it's Stephane Matteau. He scores a winner from another scramble. Watch, always a scramble. The next games were just as rock'em sock'em as the first three. After the dust had settled, the Rangers needed to win Game 6 and 7 to go on to the finals, with Game 6 in New Jersey. The captain, Marc Messier, said in the paper, "We will win Game 6," and then he went out and he got the winner in a hat trick in the third period. He took a chance and shot the puck the length of the ice because he was killing a penalty. He was not selfish. Come out heading in Game 7. They took no prisoners, I'll tell ya. Rangers are up by one goal, and the Devils have pulled their goalie. There's a mad scrambling around Richter, and it's Zalapukin with the tire with less than 10 seconds to go. A scramble again. My voice is breaking. I'm so excited. Now it's double overtime. Watch this great save by Richter. Whoa! Devils don't clear it, and Stephane Matteau scores on another scramble. Watch this. If you don't clear that puck, you're always in trouble. And on to the finals for New York. Whoa! The Leafs played Vancouver. I predicted the Canucks were just a bit too big, and they come out banging. Even their little guys were tattooing. They were playing it smart and picking on Dougie. Here's a funny one. Gardner loses his stick, and then a fan gives it back to him, and he clears the puck because they're killing a penalty. Assist to the fan. Now we're at OT and watch the great stop by Potman on Bury. I wonder why he didn't deke to his left like he did on Vernon. It's Peter Zezel with the winner, but I'm afraid that was it for the Leafs. They kept rattling, folks. Watch Pavel hammer McCowan here. Rouse jolts Cortnell. Bomber's still banging. Linden gives it to Dougie, but here comes Wendell. Delanut drills Ellett. Ellett decks Cortnell. Osborne nails Bury. This is the most disgusting thing of the season. McIntyre rubs Wendell's face with his glove. Wendell drills him, and McIntyre runs away. It's sickening. Delano whacks Gill. Gill plays the man. The Canucks were just too big and tough, and the Leafs ran out of gas. It was Greg Gus Adams that put the Leafs out with the OT goal in Game 5. Watch Trevor Linden get this cup again. I've seen this cup come off 5 times so far. What if he welded it on? Vancouver on to the finals with New York. Go back and get it, Trevor. Go back and get it. here is Paul wants the Jet to touch the puck, and then the guy would be offside. What happens? The Jet goes back onside, and look who ends up with the puck now. It always happens. Watch Mikael Anderson get his teeth knocked out here. Now, there's no blood, so I guess that's not a five-minute major. They were probably just capped anyhow. Here, hold these for me, will you? Chicklets. Looks like when I take Blue on a walk. Hey, he's holding my stick. He's holding my stick. Look out! Madonna creamed here. Now watch what happens when they're carrying him off on a stretcher. You know, I was at a party for Wendell Clark, and Mike said to me, oh, I'll bet you this makes Grapes' tape. Hey, he's okay, folks. He was laughing about it later. Don't worry about it. He's okay. Imagine Olin picks this dirty fish up. Imagine how his gloves stank after this. Oh, Lyle. Who would bring something like that into the rink? Is this the Ducks' new draft choice? Get it, folks? Mickey Mouse. I feel sorry for the mouse. Believe it or not, the ref fell for this. Roger looks a little unhappy. Barry, he's a little upset too. He uses a spear. Hey, folks, believe it or not, you can't believe the penalties in this one. I think there were 2 zillion to 2. Hey, I surrender, I surrender. The professor says it should be 5, not 4. Watch. If Sutter ever suited up for the Bruins, he'd be their toughest player. Watch the professor doing a strip tease.
Hey, folks, we're going to start off with a little coaster-coasters. End-to-enders, right, Blue? Yeah! We're going to start with the wild thing, Alia Freddy. Let's go!
Boston's wild thing, Alia Freddy. The Russian rocket, Pavel Bure. Ex-Senator Rosie Razika. The Lightning's Brian Bradley on a nice one. Kings Robert Long scores a beauty for his first NHL goal. The Sharks' Todd Elek. Nice move here, watch this. Right through the middle, whoa! Captain Scott Stevens. Plus, minus, and led his team in points through the middle, too. Little shot here, little whack back, you don't hit Scott. Here's another one by Bure, watch him fly on this one. Nice. Canucks Trevor Linden. Boy, can he move for a big guy. so nice, Trevor is doing it twice. Watch this beauty against the flame. Through the middle again. A beauty by the flame, Joe Neuwendijk. Here he goes. He's a beauty. The Leafs' Dave Vaynerchuk scores a nice one. Way to go, Dave. And now for some beauty saves. Peter Angelo.
Come on.
Patrick. Patrick again. Patrick again. Patrick again. Rookie of the year, Martin Brodeur. Walk-a-lock. The set. Herbie. Roussel. Draper. Flopping around like a fish out of water, but he makes the save. McLean. Cujo.
Crossbar. The Canucks feed it up to Ronning.
Over to Gus Adams. And in. Vancouver wins game one. Now we're in Vancouver and the rocket still goes on. Most exciting thing in sports, I think, a penalty shot. Pavel gets pulled down on a breakaway. Now it's Pavel and Richter. He digs to his left like he did against Vernon when he scored the winner versus the Flames, but Richter's ready for that one. The Rangers go on to win the game and take a 3-1 series lead. Jelinek gets zonked by Noonan. Now the score for Vancouver going into the third period in Game 5 is 1-0, and it turns out to be the strangest period of the playoffs. Watch. Cardinal makes it 2-0. Murray makes it 3-0. The Rangers start to come back. Lidstrom makes it 3-1. Larmer makes it 3-2. And the captain, Mark Messier, makes it 3-3, scoring from his favorite spot. Vancouver comes right back and makes it 4-3. Nice goal by Babich. Mike says if they score one more goal, I'm going to St. Louis. And Cardinal makes it 5-3. Mike says that's it, I'm going to St. Louis. Murray makes it 6-3. 8 goals in one period. In game 7, Adam Graves makes it 2-0 for the Rangers. Hey, just because it was game 7 didn't mean they stopped rattling, folks. Makes the score 3-2 in the third. Nice passes by the Canucks. Vancouver almost ties it up here, but Richter makes a great save. Lafayette rings one off the post. They were that close to sending it into overtime. But the Rangers win it 3-2 in 7 games. What a great finals, I'll tell you, for hockey. More hits here. We'll be right back.
folks, it's tea time for you guys that don't like to see him drop. And we're going to start off with the Winnipeg boy, Mike Keane. Blue's ready to go. And the Boston Strong boy, I'll tell you, you know him, Bill Guerin. These are a couple of cruiserweights. We're ready to go. Are you ready? Let's go.
Now watch this here one. I'll bet you think we speeded up the film here. I'll tell you, folks, there was 76 punches thrown here. Bill and Mike are really going at it, I'll tell you. They're not wasting any time. Linesman letting them go. Nobody really hurt, though, as I said before. Getting a little tired right now, though, I'll tell you. Watch Bill, he's laughing as he's skating off. Like I say, nobody's hurt. Mike's not laughing, though. Lots of fun. And now we have one that, I don't know whether you call this a fight or not. Odd Boyven and Yami Yeager. Now, Claude, he doesn't know what to do. He sees him there. He doesn't know what to do, punch him or what. Here comes Mario. Watch, Mario comes along. And here he comes. You leave him alone. Folks, we're not fooling here. Here are the two best heavyweights in the league, I'll tell you. Right, they start off a little slow. Here they come. Watch the puck coming around. They're saying, you want to go? You want to go? Watch here. You want to go? You want to go? Look at the glove flying right there. Now, they start off, like I say, a little slow, but they're going. This fight lasted a minute and 43 seconds, I'll tell you. Longest fight I've ever seen. And no clutching and grabbing, let me tell you. Think the players aren't interested? When you see the crowd in the background, bad camera shot here, I'll tell you. Now we got a head in the front. Get that head out of the way. Two right-handers here, but once in a while you see a left going. The equipment. Bob keeps his equipment on pretty good. There goes Marty. See how Probert turns his head to the side all the time when you're trying to hit him with a right. Boy, they're not fooled. You can't believe how tired they get in this one, folks. Ryan with the uppercut. See, Bob lets him up. I tell you, he really did let him up. I tell you, there's honor amongst these guys. I know I was one of these guys at one time, I'm happy to say. Look at the crowd in the background. Yeah, you people that say they don't like fights. Now watch here. They asked Marty. No. He said, you want to stop? No way. See Marty say no? They're still going. What do you expect them to say, yes? I can't believe. Bob said after the fight, he told somebody, I was so tired, I was almost sick to my stomach. Two great guys going at it. Now you'll see near the end, you'll see them bop heads at the end there. Two warriors going at it with respect for one another. Now watch, they bop heads there. They're looking at one another. They touch heads. Now watch them. Touch them on top of the head. I'll tell you, folks, that was the battle of the decade. Two beauty guys going.
Hey, folks, you can see Blue's tired, so it's time to go. Gee, I hope you enjoy these Rock'em Sock'em tapes because Blue and I love bringing them to you. We're going to end with some beauty goals, but you kids, stay tuned after. Blue and I got some messages for you, okay? Thanks for watching, folks. See you next year, God willing. All right, we're going to have a few tips for some of you kids that want to listen how to play hockey and how to survive in hockey. You ready? Let's go. Hey, kids, I want to cry sometimes when I see you walking on cement with skates. I know you don't think it's a big deal, but if you were paying for the sharpening, you would. You know when you blackboard, you put your fingernails on it, and it drives you nuts? That's what drives me nuts, seeing you kids walk on cement with your skates. Don't walk on cement. You know, a lot of you people are going to think this is silly, this is not important, but I'm telling you one of the most important things I feel, if my son was playing, would he'd have his own water bottle. You never know what's going on. You see the kids put their mouth around it like that. Worst of all, you see them taking the top off like this, putting the thing down, drinking it out like that. I'm telling you folks, I kid you not, I talked to a father last year in Mississauga. As God love him, his young boy died at 10 years old. And he swears he caught meningitis off a water bottle. So please, please, get your own water bottle, put your name on it, and don't let anybody else drink it but you, okay? See that? They're my gloves that I used in Rochester when I played. Now, I know you can't use gloves like these, but don't get them too short, guys. You remember what happened to Mario when Adam Graves slashed him? If he had had these gloves, he'd have been all right. Don't get them too short. Please, save your wrists, all right? Remember, a little tip. All right, you see how I'm going into the corner now? I got my head down like this. You never, ever go into the corner like this. This is how you go into a corner. Watch me now. All right, if I'm going into the corner, I always go into the side. I'm going into the side. I'm not going straight in. And I'm always taking a peek. I'm always taking a peek. Mario, you ever see him go in the corner like that? Only one time Gretzky ever went in. You remember in Team Canada when Suter got him? He always knows where everybody is. It's not chicken, you know. It's not chicken to take a peek. You should know where the big defenseman is. You should know where the other forward is. When you go into a corner, take a peek of what's going on. Pick up the puck. Go like this. Never go blind into a corner. Remember that, kids. This is the most dangerous part of hockey. In the corner. Be careful in the corners. Remember that. See, I got Eric there. I hit him pretty hard. I cannot hurt Eric there. You know why? He's up against the boards. You can't get hurt when you're up against the boards. Watch Kirk Muller. Watch Gilmore. Watch Sezel, the good corner guys. They're up against the corner going like this with one hand, kicking the puck. You can hit them as hard as you want, and you won't hurt them. But I'm going to show you how you can get hurt in the corners, okay? Let's go. See where Eric was standing there? He was standing this far from the boards. This is no man's land. This is where you can get hurt. This is where the defensemen pick you up and ride you into the boards. Never, ever, ever stand like this with the puck going in the corners like this. No man's land. Remember, up against the boards and you'll never get hurt, okay? You just saw the most cowardly act in hockey and the most dangerous. Kids, when you're going in the corner, first of all, Eric shouldn't have been like that. He shouldn't have been like that, but if he is, kids, please, 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 think first. Never hit anybody into the boards. This is so important. It's the cheapest shot of all time. I'm begging you right now, don't, when you see anybody next to the boards with his head down, hit him head first into the boards. I'm pleading with you. It's a cowardly act, and I hate it. And everybody in hockey, from Wayne Gretzky, Mario, Bobby Orr, down the hall, they call a guy that does that a cheap shot artist, and don't you do it. Geez, you see the way Eric hit me there? I can't understand it, why you kids are using football tactics now. Look, if you're going to hit somebody, have your head up. I see it all the time at the tournaments. Just because you got the big mask on the helmet, you think you're impervious. You like that word? Impervious to getting hurt. You gotta hit with your head up. What happens if I jump out of the way, he hits his head, and you know what happens then? Keep your head up at all times. And now look, if you get hit and you go down, Don't roll around on the ice letting on your hurt trying to draw a penalty. That's not the Canadian way. You know, they do that over in Europe, like soccer or something. Don't fall down and let on your hurt. Don't cry wolf, because if you cry wolf, they won't send anybody out after a while. Remember a few years ago in Calgary when Montreal was playing the Flames and Claude Lemieux fell down? Pat Burns, the coach, wouldn't send the trainer out. He was faking it. Canadians aren't fakers. If you're hurt, okay, you can't move, all right. But if you're not hurt, get up and play the game the Canadian way, all right? Hey, you know what bugs me? I'll tell you what bugs me. When I see a big guy picking on a little guy, knocking him down, trying to hurt him. If you want to pick on somebody your own size, okay? That's the Canadian way. Yeah, this is what we used to call the wand in the Boston Bruins. And you know who that is? Bobby Orr. What a hockey player, the greatest hockey player who ever lived. You know, talking about sticks, I go to a lot of tournaments, you know, and I see the kids after, when they lose the tournament, they take and break their sticks and fall down and cry. You don't do stuff like that. Why give satisfaction to the other club? You think the Vancouver Canucks, when they lost in that seventh game, they didn't want to break their sticks and act stupid? Never, ever do that. Stand along that blue line and take it. Another thing, too, I saw coming, and I think it's great what we're doing in Canadian hockey. Unless it's a tournament where there's a lot of goals, I saw teams up 6-1 on visiting teams from the States and over the pond. They never run up the score. I actually saw one of the goalies on the Canadian team, to make the other team feel good, let a goal in. That's the way to do it. Don't rub it in. Don't be a wise guy. And when you do get a goal and it's 6-1, don't be a hot dog and jump around. It's not the Canadian way. Now remember, kids, when you're playing hockey, you play hard, you play fair, you play for fun, but you keep your head up and your stick down, all right? See you later. Let's go, Eric. Now look, Eric, you gotta take this here, put it like that, take the thing, shoot it in the net. You missed the net, you can't, what are you doing? You're supposed to hit the net.